Changing the blades on the Norwood HD36 band sawmill is a quick and easy process. In this video, I'll show you how to do it in under 4 minutes. The easiest way to change blades is to roll the mill to the end of the track so that you can easily reach the blade. Then adjust the carriage height to a comfortable working level. There are 4 rubber fasteners on each of the shields that need to come off, and there's also a blade guard on the idler side band wheel that needs to come off. With the shields off, loosen the blade, then push in on the T-handle to push the band wheel to loosen it a bit more. Sometimes it also helps to push down on the blade to loosen it. And be sure to wear gloves. Handling those blades is like shaking hands with a piranha. It's easiest to take the top part of the blade off first, then slip the bottom part out from between the guides. Coiling the blade is easier to do than it is to explain. Hold it so that it is in a circle with the teeth pointing away from you and the bottom touching the ground. Position your hands about a fourth of the way around the blade with your thumbs parallel to the blade pointing away from you. Sort of like you're hitchhiking in both directions. Then push down a little on the blade and roll your wrist so that your thumbs point forward. The blade becomes saddle-shaped. Keep rotating your wrists and moving them downward until the blade coils up into thirds. And that's all there is to it. Uncoiling a sharp blade is just about a reverse of the process, though some people find it easier to just give the blade a good toss instead. Slip the sharp blade onto the band wheels and through the blade guides, then straighten it up along the top. Do your best to center the blade on the band wheels. Then tighten the T-bar to about the same tension where it was. Next, spin the wheel a few times and check the tracking, that is, where the blade rides on the band wheels. You want the body of the blade to be roughly centered on the band wheels. If necessary, adjust the tracking. Blades tend to stretch with use, and they may require some adjustment. When you're satisfied with the blade tension and tracking, give the bearings a shot of grease. These are not sealed bearings, so it's a very important part of the blade change procedure. You're now ready to replace the blade shields. Make sure to attach all the rubber fasteners and the blade guard. The shield on the driven side has a connector to a shutoff on the top that must be engaged or the engine will not start. And that's it. You're ready to get back to work.